Saloon Talk is brought to you by
Radiant. Look good, feel great.
According to Pacheco, if you know you sent your child with a cheat, please allow. You are not obliged to participate in this thing called Valentine's Day. You have been excused. Please.
You just tell your wife. Please allow. Don't involve buying stuff. You just tell her good things, tell her good stories. You sing for her.
Yeah.
Yes. Things that don't involve cash.
Good sex.
Uh-huh.
You go and read the Kama Sutra.
Uh-huh.
And then be like, baby, I've come home for you. Then, and just for you.
Uh-huh.
Someone taught us about the bamboo split. You got your lad.
Who is that? Who told you about that?
What was her name? She was called Gracious.
Mm-hmm.
Gracious told us about the bamboo split as like the things women are doing to men. I beg. Cool. So she wants chocolate. Chocolates are very affordable. And let me advise your boyfriend. Anyone who wants to dead jolly, you know what you do? You go to the big supermarkets and buy the tins that come with a couple. She will lose it. She'll get used to it and she'll be like, whatever.
But not a lot because I don't have to gain weight.
There we go.
You know what I mean? When you feel like you've figured out the whole dating thing, a model comes up with something else. So you have to feed me, but you can't give me so much.
Yeah, and you have to start saving for that photo shoot.
So how much do you have? We'll get into the photo shoots later. But for now, Valentine's Day. So chocolates, movies. Why go to the movies instead of me creating an experience at my house? I'm saying if I'm a guy.
That would be after the movies.
No. Yeah, after that. Create the experience at home. Have my LED HD curve TV. 55 inches, darling. In this room, there's a bed, there's snacks. So we watch the movie, but there was surround sound. So you're watching the movie on a beautiful screen, surround sound, popcorn,
dressing code.
Well, minimal material. Minimal material. I mean, why pay 20,000 shillings for a movie when you can experience it at its best?
No, I just want, like, being out is more nice because I'm always in the house, I'm always seeing the same TV, I'm always, yeah.
On the same bed.
Yeah, on the same bed. Yeah. So you go out, you move, and yeah.
And still, movies are affordable. I think Jolly is, among all the women we've had on the show, I think Jolly is affordable. I mean, we've had worse. You know what I mean?
And I think it would be better if she married a photographer. She would become more affordable. If she wants to have photo shots, then the camera is in the house.
Some socialites in Uganda have decided to do that. They are dating photographers on the side while they're also dating a financier. You never know.
There's only one who married a photographer.
I'm saying socialites are on the side dating.
I know one who married the photographer. I think maybe that was the reason as to why she decided to marry a photographer. The man would take her photos from all angles and anywhere.
On and off bed.
Hello.
So what do you think about that?
That's fine, but not marrying a photographer. No.
Why? You want photo shoots every now and then, so it's
yeah,
better
you
get married to a photographer.
Yeah, I love them, but maybe with time I can be able to afford them myself. Then, yeah, I have to be an independent woman.
So Valentine's Day, chocolate and movies. That's
like it's only one day, so like we have more other days.
So what other things? So if you're in a relationship, what other things do you expect your man to celebrate?
Celebrating my success. If there is something I do, that like a milestone I achieve.
You're not one of those chicks who do first time I kiss, first time.
Really, I have to keep them in mind. No. No.
So for you, you feel like, so then what are you going to do for the guy?
For that guy?
Yeah.
Yes.
You avail yourself.
Photo shoots, is it affordable?
She avails herself.
Maybe.
24. hours.
Well, I do. I bet she does that even when it's not Valentine.
24/7.
Weekend, full bonanza.
Kabisa.
Uh-huh. What are you saying?
Most men love watches.
They love watches. You get him a watch. I'm like, what kind of brands? You know, women, once you learn that your man loves something, you read about brands. I don't know, Skagen, you read about the Rolex, if you can afford it, for sale. What other brands are there? Casio. Those are affordable brands.
Why do you say affordable? They also have they're different. It's Casio, yes, but different kind of brands.
They're those that are for like $2,000 and those that are for $40. Oh, yes, you're right.
Yeah, so I get that one. That's affordable.
But are you going to get him a watch every Valentine's?
No.
So in marriage, there's also a timetable.
At times, I think we need one. Yes. Because there are times, like today, it's a very busy day for me.
Yes.
Now, if I go home and she tells me, she has been reading this Kama whatever thing since morning.
You find her, and she's in a situation, uh-huh. She's feeling a certain way.
Exactly.
She and wants the situation taken care of.
Sleep.
Yes. No. Hold it right there. When a man comes home late, we've had this conversation before. Some of these men treat women like machines. He's come home late. Chick has been home taking care of the kids, getting them ready, cooked, cleaned, did everything she was supposed to do. Comes home at 3 a.m. and taps her. Baby, expecting chow. And should she decline? Should she show that she's not interested? It will be an issue. He will call the singer. Am I right or wrong?
You're right in a way and wrong in the other.
You know what I mean? So it's an issue when she's not interested.
Why do you bring in the nothing? You know, there are things we do, and then women will say, no, you know me, I had all that at home. We had the food, we had the dresses, we had all this. This is why I came. And then why do you forget why you came at times? Why you left your home? Because it is the only reason as to why you left your home, because you had food, you had dresses, you had friends. And you came to me.
Okay. But at the end of the day, she's a human being.
And
you
so,
get tired, right?
And yeah. So am I.
We all get tired.
Right?
Yeah.
There are certain instances where you're not ready for chow, right?
Yeah.
Actually, it also depends from which, culture you come.
From? Really?
Yeah.
There are certain cultures where a woman can't get tired. She's supposed to be.
In my culture,
she's supposed to be on alert.
In my culture, women don't get tired, and they'll even tell you, "Mkazi tako." You know, I've done this. I'm tired. How? You are a woman. You're not supposed to get tired. That is what sengas tell their girls.
My senga didn't tell me that, and I think I come
from
the same culture.
Maybe she will tell you at the right time.
I refuse.
Last time lectures. You wait for those last time lectures.
Are you
serious? They come at the 11th hour. I leave my father's house, you come to my house, and you know why you have come.
Then you get here and then you start telling me you are tired. We have all left.
Yes, exactly, right?
We have all sacrificed.
Yes.
And we have all come for the same thing.
It is good you are saying you have sacrificed. So sacrifice again and again.
So
don't
Jolie,
say you are tired, you sacrifice.
Back to Valentine's Day. Jolie, do your parents tell you whether they used to celebrate Valentine's
Day? No.
Do you think they used to celebrate?
Yeah, I think they did.
You think they did?
Yeah.
Do you think there are certain men who say Valentine's is useless and it's an excuse women use to get free gifts? And chow.
Yeah, there are men who say that. There are men who say that.
Yeah,
shamelessly.
Shamelessly, I know. Do you agree with that?
I don't agree.
You think it's important for a relationship to celebrate Valentine's Day?
Sometimes when you can.
Would you leave a man because he doesn't know this culture called celebrating Valentine's Day?
No, I wouldn't.
You would stay, yeah. Cook, love him, be there for him?
Yeah.
See? So then why celebrate it anyway? Why expect anything if you know it's not a big deal?
You have to have a really good reason why we are not celebrating it, and I'll have to understand.
What's a good reason to you?
Maybe you don't have the money right now.
That's a good reason.
Yeah.
And that can be a good reason for the rest of his life. Oh, Jolie's an understanding woman. I've had a couple of ladies here and she's quite understanding.
But even these Valentine's things, you know, for you young people, yes?
Mm.
you can indulge much into them, into Valentines. But for those of us who have lived for some good time, these things have just come yesterday, the other day, you know. Previously, we didn't have that rubbish.
In high school, you never celebrated Valentine's Day.
With who?
Patrico, you're just trying to be funny now. Honestly.
I'm telling you, these Valentine's things have started, I think, in the 90s. That is when people started talking much about them. But now those of us who are here in the 80s, we even didn't have time for that. You celebrate love. Celebrate love when you have the money, you celebrate. If you don't have, actually, even when you are in good terms, you celebrate.
Because
there is something good to celebrate.
Oh, okay.
Now celebrate love. Me, I'm loving you 365 days a year. And then why do you want me to celebrate?
You're loving
me
even while you're cheating.
Cheating. No, I'm a Catholic. We don't cheat.
What is it called? If Catholics don't cheat, what is it called? Because I have seen so many.
Mention two. Not the so many. Leave all the others and give us two that you know. Anyway. But that is it. Valentine's, this idea of Valentine's, I think, came around the 90s. That it started becoming
too much.
But previously, you would be with your woman. When you have the money, you buy her stuff. If you don't have, you leave.
All right.
Valentine's, it meant Valentine's fell on any day. It doesn't have to be the 14th of February.
Ah, Patrico, I said it. However, like I said earlier, if you sent your kids to school with a cheat, please stay away from Valentine's Day. And from the conversation, we've learned that, you know, maybe women are willing to compromise. If there's no money, she will let it go. However, if you have the money, think outside the box. Like Robert said, if you're a chick, take him to a different room that is not your bedroom or his bedroom. Perhaps a 4-star hotel. Not a 5-star, because those are expensive, Robert, during this time. Even a 3-star would go. Thank you so much, Patrico, for coming through. We've come to the end of the show.
Thanks a lot.
We need to bring him back, right? I know. Vote. Hashtag SalonTalk. Should we bring him back? It was so much fun. Say hi to Mama Jojo. You know, I'm right.
Now you're going to cause problems. They'll ask me now, who is Jojo? I'm telling you, this kind of life that we live in is a bit tricky. The name is Majo.
Okay. It's a...
Majo.
Oh, Majo.
If you say Jojo, they'll ask me who Mama Jojo is.
But it's close.
Not so close. They might think I did it intentionally.
Yo. Okay, got it. Got it, Mama. Mama Majo. Got it. So how do we keep up with your work? You know, follow you, social media?
At times, social media becomes a problem.
Okay, so when are
Why?
You in theater?
Because
when are you in theater? See. When are you on the air?
You know? No, you can get me on social media.
Yes.
I'm there. You can always get me. Like I said, at times it brings problems.
Yeah.
You people post things that she reads before I do. Because if I read them first, I delete.
Oh, but then now it shows deleted this message.
Yeah,
so you have to be careful.
She asked me for the message.
Oh, okay.
The problem is when she reads before I do. But I'm there. You can get me at Back Valley Theatre.
Yes.
You can get me at the radio.
Yes.
I'm getting into politics to make it easier for people to get me.
No way.
Yes, I'll be telling you soon. Get me at Parliament.
No way. Yes way? No, yes way?
Get me at Parliament.
So, question. Don't
go there.
So we're going to let... Jolly, how do you... Like what social media?
You can find me on Facebook, Jolly Aweko. Instagram, Jolly Aweko.
Do we have some nudies, professionally taken nudies?
Those ones are yet to come.
We're waiting, so do follow so you can get them firsthand. I told you guys I love you. Give you only nothing but the best. Cream de la cream. My name is Judith Yana. Make sure you come to Spectra Salon and Spa. That's in Bugolobi, Middle East, next to the Middle East Family Clinic. Now, also, if you want to get my wig, Zuri Luxury Hair, Crane Plaza Kisementi, shop number B16. Otherwise, I love you. Now, apenda sana. Bye-bye.
Salon Talk is brought to you by
Radiant. Look good. Feel great.